Hey guys, today I want to talk about this PC Gamer article that was recommended to me. I believe in a Twitter or something like that. I saw a tweet and it caught my attention. I haven't read the article. I am going to do it right now with you guys. But it caught my attention that it says class balance is still an absolute joke in Diablo 4, but the game has far bigger problems. Of course, this title caught my attention, so I want to take a look at it, brother, and see what is happening. So let's just do it, brother. Let's just do it. They say in here, I no longer care who needs buffs and nerfs. None of these classes are any fun to play. Brother, and I am going to disagree right away. Because, well, I am going to agree and disagree. Because I do agree that the balance is kind of a joke, brother. We know this. Of course, we are huffing the copium. Hoping that later in the game balance the classes balance out when they get gear, you know, like classes that are slow right now, like the druid or the barbarian, get really good with gear later in the game. But we don't know if this will be the case for sure until we get there, right? So we are hoping the copium that everything is going to be okay. But right now the balance has been lackluster, brother, and I think that if the experience from 1 to 20 without Paragon Boards, without Glyphs, without aspects for the legendaries, without uniques, is this unbalanced, brother, at high level when everybody has all this bullshit that is difficult to juggle around, I don't know if the balance will be fucked up, but it will be hard to balance. So you can assume or you can extrapolate that if they don't know how to balance early game, late game will be worse. But of course, I hope that is not the case. Now, having said that, then he goes on to say, and this is the part that I disagree, none of these classes are any fun to play. I completely disagree. I believe that the druid is really fun to play. I love my druid, brother. I turn myself into a big fucking wolf or a big fucking bear. I summon storms. I create earthquakes. I go around with two wolves that if you get the correct aspect, those wolves turn into werewolves. How awesome is that? The game is fun, brother. The game is fun. And the classes are fun too. Well, you know what class I don't like? Sorcerers. Fuck sorcerers. But I played the druid and the rogue, and they are really fun, brother. The rogue is fun as fuck. If you wanna play a really fun class, of course I recommend the druid because I like the druid, but the druid is right now in the early game the weakest one. If you want the strong one that is really fun to play, brother, the rogue. The rogue is really fun to play and it's strong. So I don't agree with the classes are not fun to play. So having said that, let's go into the article, brother. They say in here, it's fair to say that last time we got to Diablo 4 during the two initial weekend betas, class balance was a complete mess. Agree. Sorcerers were nuking everything inside while barbarians struggled to lift their axes, and necromancers were standing around AFK watching their skeletons clear entire dungeons for them. That is true too. Blizzard quickly promised buffs and nerfs, so heading into this final beta, the server slang, I was most curious to see what those changes would amount to. The result, I'm left with an even less confidence that Blizzard has any idea how to make this game fun. I don't have the same perspective, brother. I have the perspective that they are having difficulties with balance, but the game is fun as fuck, brother. The game is really fun. You can't say that this game is not fun, brother. It is, in fact, one of the most fun games that I have played, brother. The combat is fluid. It is beautiful. It is responsive. You feel great when you cast your abilities. Brother, have you cast a full pulverize with overpower with your druid? There is nothing more satisfying and fun than that shit, brother. Going with trample head on into enemies, brother. You can say to me that the game is not fun, motherfucker. I don't agree with that. And balance is fixable, brother. Balance is fixable. What if they hit their stride and then they figure out what is the proper balance? Everything will be great because the core game is there. And that is the fundamental disagreement that I have with this article. They are saying that balance is not the problem, but that the game is fundamentally flawed. And I don't agree with that. Maybe balance is fucked up, but the game at its core is a really good game, brother. It is a really good game. It feels great, it has immersion, it looks good, the controls, the gameplay is the best fucking check that I have ever played, so I don't know what this dude is talking about, brother. Barbarians at least felt a little stronger than they did before. It wasn't too back-breaking to beat the Den Mother this time around. The Den Mother is the werewolf boss from the Lights something. It is called the Dungeon, the Lights whatever. And it is a kinda... I don't think it is the hardest boss, but it is a kinda hard boss. To me, the hardest boss is one that is a spider. I don't remember the name, but that fucking spider puts like spider webs on the ground, and if you step on the spider webs, you get stuck. Brother, that boss is a pain in the ass. At least for the druid, it was. Then they say, but they are still substantially slower, weaker, and less versatile than anyone else. Than anyone else, more than the druid. I don't think so, buddy. Sorcerers remain walking nukes that can kill enemies 3 screens away. Fuck sorcerers, brother. It is so stupid. I hope they fall hard on the late game, brother. Sorcerers are for pussy bitches, my dude. Meanwhile, necromancers got nerfed so haphazardly that they had to get rebuffed halfway through the beta test. That was because of the skeletons. Because the skeletons' minions were now dissolving in the presence of bosses and leaving them blinking away with pitiful ranged spells. I didn't play necromancer, so I don't know how shitty it was, but if they had to patch it to make a hotfix in the middle of a 2-day beta, brother, it must have been really fucking bad. It must have been really fucking bad. Because, brother, it is a beta. You can't just wait and fix it afterwards before the game launches. But no, they fix it in the middle of the 2-day beta. It must have sucked really big dick, brother. Okay. In short, class balance is still an absolute joke. And worse still, Blizzard has shown no sign of having any vision for what direction changes should be going in. So again... yes, class balance has been lackluster. Let's be honest, guys. We can hide this fact. Balance has been a little lackluster. But there are two things to consider in here. First, what we already said. Maybe this is intentional because everything will change in the future when we get to late game. We could argue that it doesn't matter if things balance out later because at early game, if it is not fun, you are less inclined to get to late game. You shouldn't have to do a chore to get to late game, grueling through the early game. That is bad design, let's be honest, guys. But let's assume that everything will get better later. But the other problem is that balance is not that big of a deal, brother. Balance can be fixed easily. It is just numbers. You just try to get to the point where things are balanced. What is important is the fundamental design of the game, brother. Sure, this is still a beta, but the launch is due June 6th with early access on June 1. We're very unlikely to see substantial tweaks before then. Right now, we're looking at a day one where sorcerers and barbarians are not so much playing different games as operating on different planes of reality. You know what, guys? This dude might be a hater, but he's right on this one. They are not playing. Me as a druid, I am not playing the same game, level 1 to 10, level 1 to 20, as a fucking sorceress, brother. We are not playing the same game, dude. I am, you know that clip where there is a dude that is singing around while he's playing, and then there is another dude that is sweating, like playing hard, boo, 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 boo. Well, I am the one that is playing hard with the druid, and the sorceress is fucking dancing around, brother. That and singing around, that is the truth, my dude. Then they say, but really, the class imbalance is just a symptom. The real problem is that it doesn't matter whether your favorite class is fighting on all cylinders or shooting blanks. None of them are much fun to play, and this is when we come to a disagreement. I believe that the class imbalance is a problem that can be fixed, but I do like... well, I do feel that classes are fun to play. At least the two that I am recommending are fun to play. I like the druid, and I like the rogue. Both of them are fun to play to me, brother. Class dismiss, they say. For a barbarian, the game is boring because it's a long, slow slog of walking at the spongy hellbars. We know that this dude played a barbarian, and he didn't like what the barbarian felt like, and he's pissed off. That is what is happening here, boys. It is obvious that this dude played a fucking barbarian, and he didn't like it. For a sorceress, the game is boring because you just throw out a handful of very similar spells that work in all situations and things melt in your presence. I do agree with that. Sorcerers are bland as fuck. They are boring, brother. Oh, Frostball! Oh, Fireball! The two same fucking spells that you have been throwing for 20 fucking years in every game, in every RPG that has some kind of wizard in there. Sorcerers are boring, brother. So I do agree in this part. At no end of the spectrum has Blizzard found satisfying, interesting gameplay loops other than the endless treadmill of watching the numbers incrementally go up. For some people, that is fun. Plus, I do think that the Rogue and the Druid have fun gameplay. I don't say the other classes because I haven't played them enough to say to you with confidence, you know. A Necro player or a Barbarian player would have to come and say, oh yes, they are fun to play. I don't know. But I do know that the Druid and the Rogue are cool, brother. They are cool, for sure. As I lamented during the last beta, Blizzard hasn't learned anything about action RPG combat in the 11 years since Diablo 3. I go so far as to say it's a step backward. As I went into them, fights are slow and awkward, with any potential interesting combos or loops hamstrung by long cooldowns and prevent any kind of satisfying reading. I disagree. In fact, I didn't play a lot of Diablo 3, I just played a little bit, but I have seen a lot of videos of people playing Endgame, brother. And Diablo 3 sucks. That zooming around and everything dies is stupid as fuck. In fact, but I love Diablo 4 combat, brother. I love that it's slow. It makes you think, it makes you move, it makes you dodge abilities, it makes you think about what abilities are you going to use. Diablo 4's combat is awesome. It feels grounded, it feels real. You feel you are there doing the stuff, not that botching. That sucks, brother. I love Diablo 4's combat, so I don't agree with this shit. In fact, I am going to say something outlandish, and maybe I am wrong, and this is just a personal preference. But Diablo 4 is the best fucking combat in any RPG that I have played. I played Lost Ark. I hate combat in Lost Ark because you get animation locked. That is stupid. I played Last Epoch. I played PoE. Torchlight 2. I don't know. Grim Dawn. Wolfen. Diablo 3. Diablo 2. Diablo 4 combat is the best one of all of them, brother. And I am going to die on this hill, brother. It is the most fun one, brother. It is the most visceral one. It gives you the most feedback when you use your abilities. It's the more fluid one. There is no fucking comparison, brother. And it is not like for a little bit for me. Diablo 4 combat is just miles better than anything else, brother. And I have just played the beta, so maybe this change when I play the end game and it fucking sucks at the end game, or it gets better. Why not think that it will get better, you know? So I don't agree with that, brother. Then they say, character building is the worst of both worlds, streamlined and restrictive, with clear intended path for characters to take, but fiddly enough that theory crafting is mostly a matter of hunting for keywords. Now, I agree a little bit more with this one. There is some nuance in there, of course, but yes, character building is not that complex as some people might want it to be. If you compare it to something like PoE, it is a lot more simple, of course. And if you compare it to Last Epoch, it is also simpler, but not that much. It is not like, oh, it is simpler, but not that much. By the way, I love Last Epoch character building, brother. It is the best system that I have played in any fucking ARPG. The Last Epoch character building, how you choose your skills, and each skill has a skill tree. Brother, that system is fucking awesome. It is better than Diablo 4's. I have to say that. I have to be honest in here, I like Last Epoch's character building system more. So yes, Diablo 4 doesn't have the most in-depth character building, but it is good enough, brother. It is better than Diablo 2-1. Yes, fire at me. It is better than the Diablo 2-1, brother. And it is better than the Diablo 3-2, brother. It is better than the Diablo 3-1-2, brother, because you have the skill tree. And on top of that, you have the Paragon board, brother. I don't know if you guys have done it, but there are several websites where you can go and you have the Paragon boards in there. I use D4 builds.gg, awesome website. In there, you can take a look at the Paragon boards, brother. And when you try to build your Paragon boards, you realize that Diablo 4's character building is more in-depth than people give it credit for. Do you need a PhD like in Last Epoch? No, of course not. Sorry, POE. No, of course not. But it is still more in-depth than people give it credit for. Our builds kinda streamlined in a path that the developer built for you. Kinda, but there are several deviations that you can take for sure. There is a space for tweaks to make your own build. It will not be that, I don't know, that there will be not as much variety as maybe you want, but brother, I was tweaking around with the builder for the druid, and I came up with over 10 different, very different builds in gameplay for the druid, brother. So I believe that it is not as streamlined as people think, and there are more possibilities that people give it credit for. It's the best fucking character building in the world. No, I already said I like the Last Epoch more, but it is not bad, and I believe it is good enough, and I believe it is fun, and I believe people will like it. Remember that Diablo 4 is appealing to a wider audience, a more casual audience. People will like it. I believe so. Even healing is wrong-headed. Spellcasters can just ignore their health, while melee characters have to plan every boss fight around when more potions are going to drop. A completely uninteresting subsystem. Now, I do agree with this one, not because healing is not well-designed. I believe healing is better designed than Diablo 2 and better designed than Diablo 3, for sure. This is the best healing that any Diablo game has ever had. This thing that you have your potion charges, you can consume it, can consume them however you want. There is no cooldown, but you only have 4 or 5 charges, and you have to pick up more charges because the boss of the elites drop them, you know? That is the best system. But it is true, brother, that ranked players have it easier for now in terms of taking hits. They can play way safer, so melee players have to be more aware of their surroundings, of not taking hits, and have to be more aware of potion management because they take more damage. This is true, at least in the first 20 levels. I don't know what is going to happen later. Then they say, there are only 2 ways to die. Either your character that can avoid getting hurt, or you simply run out of resources because your DPS isn't high enough to get to the next step of the fight, or you're a character that never gets hurt, but you take a straight hit from an obnoxious long crowd control effect and get battered down before you can unfreeze and chug a potion. That is just a skill issue, brother. Neither is at all satisfying or dramatic. Again, I like the potion system, but I do believe that there is some tweak to be made, and this can be solved with balance, brother, with just health bars and damage or armor, or the amount of damage you take between ranked and melee players. Melee players take more damage, make them more tanky. Ranked players don't take as much damage because they are safer from afar. Make them take more damage whenever they do take it, so they have to play more safe, you know? So you can solve that with balance. It is not a fundamental flaw in the game that it can be fixed with damage, with balance, you know? Horrible bosses. There is an horrible boss that I have said before that I fucking hate in the Diablo 4 campaign. But in general, I feel bosses are great. And the dungeon ones that I have played are also great. What is the one that I hate? Benard in the campaign. It is the second boss. It is the mother of the girl that you take, and Benard was taken by Lilith, and she spawns on Sukubus. That boss is stupid. It shouldn't fucking exist. I hate that boss. But boss, maybe I hate it because I play a melee druid, and it is a hard fight for that shit. And not only hard, it is annoying. But apart from that, I like every fucking boss. I believe that bosses are incredibly superior to anything that Diablo 3 gave me. And so far are better than the shit that I have played in Last Epoch and PoE. But I haven't played Uber bosses in PoE, you know? So maybe if I had played Uber bosses, I would say, oh, Uber bosses are better. But I haven't played them, you know? So I am giving that context. I know, oh, you are wrong because Maven is really good. Well, I haven't played against Maven, brother. So maybe it's better, but I don't know. For the bosses that I played throughout the campaign in POE, I like Diablo 4 bosses better. And the same goes for Last Epoch. Diablo bosses are fun, brother. I like them. I like that you go for the arrow so you get the potions. I love how you have to dodge mechanics, hidden, move around. It is really cool. It is really cool. I love it, brother. I love it. So, but Benar, fuck Benar. Change Benar completely, brother. During the server slam, everyone had one goal in mind: to kill the world boss Ashava and claim their exclusive cosmetic. But the Great Beast only ended up being the perfect capstone to Diablo's first problems. As Fraser discovered, fighting it was just a long, tedious slog that made every part of your character feel meaningless. Playing a tanky build? Pointless, because you die in one hit from one of its enormous AoE attacks. Playing DPS? Enjoy watching an enormous health bar achingly slowly tick down while you spam one spell that it has no visible reaction. Playing support? No, you aren't. That doesn't exist. Playing a necromancer? Sorry, all your skeletons got banished to double hell and they ain't coming back. All of that slow, tedious grinding of getting to level 20 culminated in an even slower, more tedious grind of a fight. I don't agree with anything that he said here. And in other paragraph, I have agreed with some things that this dude said and not others, but in this one, I don't agree with anything. Let me tell you, fighting Ashava was really fun. I enjoyed it playing as a druid that people say it is the weakest class. I enjoyed fighting Ashava. It was a really fun fight because you have to dodge stuff. You have to move around. You have to know the mechanics. You have to kill Ashava in a time frame, so you have to put out DPS, because if you don't have enough DPS, she goes away and you lose your opportunity to kill her. So DPS does matter, brother. He said it here, playing DPS, enjoy watching an enormous Helvar Ekili slowly tick down. Well, yes, because there are 12 players there fighting her, brother. So it is a 10-15 minute fight. It needs to have a lot of health, brother. Have you never played WoW or some MMO, brother? That is, WoW is like that. You are hitting a boss with 10,000 million health and your spells do nothing to them. But as a group, you are dealing damage and still it takes a longest time to kill the boss, brother. And it is still fun. You are doing your part in the DPS race, brother. And then they say here, playing a tanky build, pointless because you die in one hit. Yes, that is the point. You need to dodge the mechanics. Again, this happens in WoW 2. You have tanks that are really fucking tanky, and they also die with one-shot mechanics because there are mechanics that if you don't dodge, you deserve to die because that is how the boss is designed. Plus, there is other stuff that should be taken into account when playing against Ashava that we didn't take into account, like utilizing poison resistance elixirs, like using the gems that give you damage over time resistance, stuff like that. We went there with nothing, brother, and we still killed the boss. What the fuck are you talking about? And it was really fun. I enjoyed that the camera goes out and you see things from afar and you have to dodge stuff. It is really cool. I love the Ashava fight, brother. One thing that they need to improve with Ashava is, I know there is not much making in Diablo 4, but brother, you need to improve the gap or the range of people that go in there in levels, you know, because sometimes you go in there, you want to kill the boss. For example, in the beta, it happened that you had level 20 and then there is a dude with level 12. Don't allow that to happen, brother. Give me a range, an appropriate range of people that can kill the boss, you know? That is a change that you can do. But that doesn't have anything to do with the boss itself. It is just an extra stuff to make the experience better. So I don't agree that it wasn't fun to fight with Ashava. I don't agree a single little bit, brother. I love Ashava, brother. Even as a hardcore player, Ashava is really good. And you can't get hit. And that is the point. You have to learn the fight so well that you can't allow yourself to get hit, because you don't... And that is another thing. You don't die. You don't die. You get hit by a big fucking poison and you can survive, because I got hit and I survived. So you can't get hit. You can't... Well, with a druid with a lot of fortify, I survived, brother. So you can survive. This is not a one-shot mechanic, but it leaves you with a nasty poison debuff, and you need to use your potions, brother. So it is not that bad, brother. It is great. I love Ashava. Sure, it didn't help that Blizzard made the bizarre decision to point the soul at a level 25 boss while the beta level cap was reduced to 20. But even a faster, easier version of that fight wouldn't have been any less dull. At its core, the combat is simply half-baked. Blizzard never found the fun, whether you're adventuring alone or team fighting or teaming up for flimsy MMO-like activities. I don't agree. I found it really fun and I was playing alone. I like playing Diablo 4 alone. I don't like grouping up in Diablo. I went to the boss. I assumed like I was fighting alone and there was other people in there. I don't give a fuck about them. I hit the boss. The boss dies. I am Gucci, brother. And it was a fun experience. I enjoyed hitting the boss and dodging the boss and throwing my skills at it. I found it fun, so I don't agree with that. I'm more sure than ever that Diablo 4 is bringing nothing new to the action RPG table. Now, this is probably true. This is probably true. What is Diablo 4 doing that it doesn't already exist? So far, nothing. So far, nothing. Because Endgame is practically Mythic Plus from WoW. You are doing bosses. We have bosses since Bowser in Mario, in NES. So yes, you are doing nothing new. But you know what? You don't need to do anything new. You just need to make it fun, cool. A new way to play it, and that is good enough, brother. That is fucking good enough, dude. You bring out Dark Souls 4. Let's say you bring out Dark Souls 4, Dark Souls 4, and it is just Dark Souls 3, the same gameplay, the same bullshit, but with another map and other bosses. People would like it. It would be awesome. It doesn't need to bring something new. It can be the same bullshit, but with new stuff, and people will love it, brother. And Diablo 4 is like that. It is a new experience with cool mechanics, with cool bosses, with cool atmospheric, cool graphics, cool classes. That is all you need. The combat is fun. You don't need to create a new complicated system to make the game fun. The game is fun. And that is all that matters. That is the question to me is, is the game fun? Yes, that is it. That is it. It's big and shiny and pretty good looking. A lot of people are going to give it a pass for that. Maybe for mindlessly pushing through while you watch TV, it'll do the job for a lot of them. Elitist motherfucker. But not only is there no innovation or creativity here whatsoever, there isn't even a basic understanding of how to make an action ARPG engaging. Brother, to me, Diablo 4 is really engaging. Maybe I am a basic motherfucker, but I found Diablo 4 really, really engaging. So I don't know. I don't agree with this take at all. Yes, it is not. It is nothing new, but the game does have a fucking creativity. You can say to me that Diablo 4 doesn't have creativity, brother. Diablo 4 has creativity, brother, falling out their asses, dude. It is more creative than PoE and fucking Last Epoch. Maybe not in the character building aspect, but in everything else is better. Classes are cooler, the story is cooler, the world is cooler, the immersion is cooler. Every fucking thing is cooler. So because of one thing, are you going to say to me that it's not cooler? Fuck off. Fuck off. And that one thing is not bad. It is just not as good as the other ones. And the ineffective tweaks made so far are a sure sign that one isn't developing anytime soon. Probably Diablo 4 will have balance issues. Probably. We don't know for sure, but so far that is what we are seeing. But that doesn't make the game fundamentally flawed, brother. From a series as genre-defining as Diablo and a studio as storied as Blizzard, we should expect far better. Now, I could kind of agree that we should expect better. Far better, I don't know, because the game is look good. The game looks good. The game plays good. So it shows that it's made by a company that puts attention to these things. But there are stuff that could be better. And for a company of the status of Blizzard, it probably should have better stuff in there. I do agree with that. But it is still good, brother. But hey, the servers did hold up remarkably well. This is true. I'll give them that. At least I didn't have to queue up to get my Groot. Brother, this is true, and I hope it works like that at launch. I was debating, brother, do I really want to play the first days earlier and play 20 bucks more? But if I do that and the servers suck, I will be stuck one whole day in queue. So it won't be worth it. But now I think, oh, it will be worth it because they solved the server issue and it is going to run smoothly. So that is something that we have to give them. So yes, brother, that was this article. I feel that this dude is really biased. This dude just really hates Diablo, and that's it, brother. He played a barbarian. He didn't like it. He's cheating on every system the game has. For sure, the game has its problems, but not as big of a deal as the dude is saying in here. And the game is fun for sure. And yes, I will say it outright. The day Diablo 4 comes out, that day it will be the best ARPE on the market. You heard this. You heard it here, brother. I don't give a fuck. It is really fun. It is a good game. You spend a good time while you play the game. At least so far for me. Maybe I grow to hate it in the future. But right now, it is like that. And I can't stop thinking about Diablo 4. And I really want to play it. And I am glad that we are just like 12, 13 days away. Because I want to play this shit. So there you go, guys. Thanks for being here, guys. You are fucking awesome. God bless you. And remember, as the great Bill Hicks said, this is your surprise.